Hello everyone. In this new episode of No Sweet Talk, we are going to listen to Dr. Amar Katre, a professor of pediatrics dentistry and a senior consultant practitioner in Mumbai. He is going to discuss with us how and why sugar is addictive and what could be the ways to get rid of this addiction.
Good day, friends. We are going to talk today about addiction or substance use disorder. The word addiction, if you see the dictionary meaning, means dependence. The American Psychiatric Association has defined substance use disorder as the uncontrolled use of a particular substance despite knowing the negative consequences of the same. Typically, we use the word addiction or substance use disorder for products like tobacco, alcohol, drugs, or some other substances. The question is, can sugar be addictive? The DSM-5 criteria has stated almost 10 characters for a substance to be called as addictive, of which the most important ones are binging, withdrawal, cross-sensitization, and craving. Sugar satisfies all these criteria. Sugar activates the reward systems in our brain and facilitates the release of dopamine. This gives us a pleasurable high which we would like to experience again and again. The problem is that this is a dose dependent phenomenon. Means we have to always consume more amount of sugar to facilitate the same amount of dopamine release. This leads to binging and craving and large consumptions of sugar. Sugar also activates the opioid receptor systems in our brains, and through a complex phenomena involving certain molecules called as enkephalins. These facilitate negative consequences of sugar consumption like headaches, obesity, weight gain, hormonal imbalance, etc. It has been said that sugar possesses the same degree of addictiveness as other psychotropic drugs at a neurobiological level. An author has also said that sugar can be more addictive than cocaine because it is very easily available. It is not socially forbidden. It is steeped in our cultures. In fact, we consume sugar whenever we are happy and we would like to celebrate. Addiction is a social problem, and social problem requires a social solution. The first solution which I can immediately think of is to create a social awareness among the people about the addiction of this particular product, against the capacity of sugar to be addictive. And in this, I feel that health professionals, the health agencies and the manufacturers have to collaborate. Most importantly, I feel it is pediatric dentists who should take a lead role in this campaign. Because as pediatric dentists, we are the first ones to see the effect of a sugar overload in the form of caries or decay in the teeth. The second thing which can be done about this addiction is to make sugar more difficult to be available. It should not be as easily available and as easily consumable as it is now today. This could be done through some changes in the tax regime or some other laws which could be brought in by the relevant agencies. Those people, that includes the consumers, that includes the manufacturers, and that includes the producers who would like to opt for alternates to sugar, should be given some incentivization. It is said that our taste preferences develop early in infancy, and our choices for foods is dependent on these taste preferences. Having said so, it is equally true that we can change our taste buds, we can adapt our taste buds to consuming lesser sugar. Friends, sugar is a master deceptor. Sugar is a wolf in sheep's clothing. It is up to us to make a choice whether to expose the generations to come to this addictive substance. Thank you.